This is James Holder for IFL TV in association with Matt Fizz, Jim Arbaumer, the Leeds First Direct Arena today on the Matchroom card. With me, I've got former IBF World Champion Stewie Hall. How you doing, Stewie?
I'm all right, I'm good.
Good.
I'm good. I was a bit tired there waiting to get a fight, but...
I was going to say, how do you go from being the World Champion to then waiting for someone as a floater? It's your first floater as well, isn't it?
The last time I boxed here, it was about 1 o'clock in the morning for the world title, and I won the world title. About the same time here, but I was gloved up for 3 hours. I was a floater. I didn't get my slot. But listen, the main thing is I got in there and I done the 6 rounds and I got the job done.
Yeah, that is the main thing.
That's the main thing.
How did you feel in there, Stu?
I felt sharp. I felt very fit. It was a tough little opponent. I caught him in the first round and he just ran it. And Gamal fought him and he said he was a runner, but... He was a really good mover, but it was good workout.
How are you finding the thing since you've come over to me and fighting on the Matchroom shows?
To be honest with you, it feels like a different world, you know what I mean? Feels brilliant. I'm so glad. I'm so thankful to Eddie Hearn, the Matchroom and Sky Sports for giving me this opportunity and keep getting me on these great shows. Mm. I missed Josh's fight there because I was still warming up here with my gloves on, but I'll watch it back tomorrow and I'm glad he won. I'm glad he done the job.
What aspirations have you got for the new season? Do you still want to get yourself back in the mix and some big fights too?
Without a shadow of a doubt, I'm ready for big fights now. If this big give me a big name now, I'll be ready tomorrow. I'm staying in the gym. I'm away from my family Monday to Friday. Down Birmingham now, training with Max McCracken, Paddy Lynch and Callan Gamal, top sparring all the time, sparring 3 or 4 times a week.
Hypothetically, if I could say to you, you can be the matchmaker, you can pick your next 2 fights, who would you choose?
Well, it's, like you say, he's went. I'll say he has went a little bit past me, Jim McDonald, but I just need to keep winning, chasing him down. I'd love that rematch while we're both still hungry for the sport and both able to go the 12 rounds in a good fight. I think we've both come on, and like you say, I wish him all the best tomorrow night, but it'd be great if we could get that rematch. But like I say, if that doesn't happen, any big fights, I'll be ready for anyone.
I think everyone's rooting for him to do it again tomorrow.
Yeah, of course we are.
Going out there doing it twice is big ask, but if anyone can do it, he can do it.
Yeah, he's got a little family. I wish him all the best. I hope he does do it, but like you say, if he comes back, if he thinks he can have a little easy defence for me, because like you say, he's a bit up there now and But I'd love to give him the chance, like you say. He's the best bantamweight out there, and I think I'm the only one who maybe can beat him.
All right, well, listen, I'd love to see the fight. I think it's massive, I really do. Thank you for giving IFL TV a bit of time. Sorry I'm a bit short today, but I'm literally breezing. I'm on my way back to London, but I weren't leaving until I had a couple of minutes for you.
Yeah, thanks for
making
it.
Thank you for giving me a bit of time, mate, and I'll catch you again real soon.
Sound.
Cheers, John.